All right, let's jump into the code and see how the dates look when we use it inside our code. So if we take a look at the code I have here, this is the code that allows me to retrieve the current date and time. So you'll see here there's a line of code from date time, import date time. Said we're going to talk about libraries a little bit later. Don't stress out too much about that line of code. It's basically a way of saying, hey, there's a date time function out there that's pretty cool that someone else wrote for me. I want to use that. It's in a library. So this line of code allows me to use that other person's code in my code. And then I have a line here, date time now. So what I'm doing is I'm calling the now function of date time, and that will return the current date. And I'm storing that inside a variable. So now I have this variable current date, which contains the current date and time, and then I'm doing a print statement. And let's actually do this initially with just saying print the current date, just so you can see how that works. And go down here, and we'll run that code. Get current date dot py, and boom, code blows up. Remember we were talking about data types and type conversions. Same things will come up when you're working with dates. So what happens is we see an error that says, I can only concatenate strings. I don't know how to concatenate date times. Yeah, I actually don't know what, you know, 5th of June plus Susan equals, and neither does Python. So what we have to do is, just like when we worked with numbers, we have to convert the date into a string, because Python does know how to concatenate a string and a string together. So by converting that to a string, now I successfully get a message, today is, and you can now have the secret. You now know that Susan is recording this on the 10th of June, no matter when you're watching this. So another thing we can do, once we have a variable stored in a date time object, is there's these functions that we can call that will act on the dates. And the functions are really magical. So what I've done now is I've added a second function that I want to call at the top of the line in my code. So I'm still importing date time, but I'm calling another one called time delta. And that's a neat little function that allows me to specify a period of time, like X days, or 5 days, 3 days, 1 week, 6 weeks, and so on. So I start off the same. I ask for the current date and time, and I'm putting that into a variable called today. And I'm displaying that on the screen. So this is more or less the same code we just ran. But here's the new code. I say, let's use time delta, and say, let's add 1 day. And so I say, hey, time delta, I'd like you to add a period of 1 day. So this is a parameter you pass in. I know that from looking up the documentation of the time delta function. That's how you learn how to change the values. Whether you can pass in weeks, months, you would have to look at the time delta function documentation. But what's neat is now I can actually say yesterday equals today minus 1 day. So now I can actually do math on a date value, and then print that out on the screen. Or I could even say, down here a little lower, we'll comment this out for now, just to keep it simple. So now, if I run this code, Python date functions dot py, you can see it says today is, I said, and I'm doing this demo on the 10th of June, it says yesterday was the 9th of June. That capability of being able to subtract and add days is really, really powerful. I once worked on some COBOL code. It was a module about 1,500 lines long that basically had to convert Julian dates to Gregorian dates to figure out if it was a leap year and things like that to basically do this. So the fact that there's a function we can call that does it for us, it's huge. It's incredibly useful if you're doing anything with dates. Let's just go back to the code. I want to show you it's not limited to days. Here I passed in days equals 1, but I could have just as easily, if we comment that out, I have a line here and I say, what if we subtract a week? So when I call the time delta function, I ask it to do a delta of 1 week, and then I subtract 1 week from today. Well now, if I go and run that code, we can see it comes back and goes, yep, 1 week ago, if today is the 10th, 1 week ago was the 3rd of June. Said, and it takes care of all that stuff, like was this month 30 days or 31 days, and is it a leap year, is all taken care of for me. So time delta is an example of one of the neat functions you can play with dates. There's a lot out there. Suffice to say, if you want to do something with a date, do a little searching. You may find a function that does it for you before you have to start coding it yourself. Now, when you're displaying a date to somebody, you probably need to format it. You may not always want the full date, hours, minutes, seconds, and milliseconds. So if we take a look at this code here, what I've done is I'm actually extracting just the part of the date that I'm interested in. I start off again by saying I want to use the DateTime function in the DateTime library because it's such a great feature. I ask for the current date and time by asking for DateTime now, storing that in the variable called today. And then what I'm doing is if I ask today.day, that will return just the day portion. Today.month, the month portion, year of the year, hour of the hour, and so on. So then I can take those values and display them all on the screen. So I can access whatever part of the date that I want. You're not forced to display the full date every single time. So that way you can extract the components you need and just use the parts you're interested in. Now, sometimes when you're working with dates, you run into some interesting complications. Let's say you want to read a value that's coming out of a file or a database or a user is giving you a date. Unfortunately, most of the time when you read a date from a file, a database, or from a person, it'll be treated as a string when it's read by Python. But if I want to use these cool date functions, I need it to be treated as a date time data type. So once again, I'm going to have to do data type conversions. Now I need to convert from string to date. But how do I know whether you gave me the date as day, month, year, or month, day, year? And did you use slashes or dashes? All these extra complications. So I have some code here that will actually take a string and convert it to a date. What you'll see is I ask somebody to enter their birthday, so I'm using an input statement, and I tell them, please give me the date in this format. The user may not read the instructions, but I at least want to remind them the format I'm expecting. And then what I do is I use this strip time function. So what this does is it strips elements out of the string and converts it into a date time format. So you say, here's the string, birthday, that contains the string someone typed in, and then I have to tell it what format I think the date's going to be in. %D, day first, then month, %M, then percent uppercase Y, which means four-digit year. How did I know those values? I looked up the documentation on the strip time function. That's how you learn the syntax for this. Then I can print out a value on the screen, and I can use that time delta function to say what was it one day before my birthday and all those great things. So let's just try this out and see if it works. And I'm going to go ahead and run my code, input date. And it says, when is my birthday, day, month, year? My birthday is clearly on the 6th of June, 1999. So I run, and it says, your birthday is the 10th of June, and the day before your birthday was the 5th of June. So you can see, I know it successfully converted it to a date because I'm able to use those date time functions, that time delta. But what if the person who is running your code isn't paying attention? And they say, oh, when's my birthday? Oh, it's the 30th of February. Or maybe they just enter a valid date, but they enter dashes instead of slashes. So 10/19/99. So they enter something that doesn't match that format that I'd said the date would be received in. Well, boom, here goes the code blowing up all over the place. So this is one of those situations where you know this error is going to happen occasionally in your code. So what you should do here is add some exception handling. So I think maybe we should look at that in the next module.